joining us, sir.
Good morning and happy new year to all of you also.
And happy Tweede Nuwejaar to you as well. There have been some hiccups along the way when it comes to preparations. The proceedings begin today is what we understand throughout the week. And are you ready? Is it all systems go?
It's all system go from our side. Everything is ready. Obviously, the march has been moved to the 4th for logistic reasons, time reasons, and also because it infringes on the Muslim calendar.
Tell me, let's unpack the issues now. There have been several issues that have been plaguing preparations, as I mentioned in the intro. Where do we begin? Let's start with the dispute between the mayor and the minstrel organizations over the middleman. That has since been resolved, we understand. But how has that dispute affected the Tweede Nuwejaar celebrations?
Well, it hasn't affected the celebrations. In fact, it made us more determined to make a success, because now that we have been involved as an organization to be part of the arrangements and the operation and everything about the minstrels, we also want to make it a success. So yeah, everything is in place.
We understand that some of the minstrel groups were going to wear armbands, ANC armbands, in honor of Utata Nelson Mandela, who was the patron of the proceedings. The entry of politics into this has also somewhat ruffled a few feathers. How have we resolved that issue?
No, we find that was malicious rumor spread by people that did not want the process to go on track. We had an agreement with the city of the mayor and obviously the Triple KE. We had an agreement that we will work together. We will, of course, be wearing armbands, but not in the way that they have described it. We will be wearing armbands with Nelson Mandela, Tata Madiba's face, because he was a patron of our organization.
And let's get to this last issue out of the way so we can focus more on the actual proceedings. ANC Western Cape leader Mr. Marius Fransman has allegedly been approached by some of the minstrel organizations to be the new patron after the passing of Tata Madiba. Some people saying that further adds fuel to the fire and bring politics to the fray, threatening the whole event. What do you have to say about that?
I don't think that his patronship will affect the event. In fact, it will enhance it, because Mr. Fransman has been doing a lot of things behind the scene. In fact, he was instrumental in making the upcoming carnival, a reality, because there was a dispute and we would have gone to court. Mr. Marius Fransman, then he's been working with us for quite some time, and we said that he's doing everything in his power to help us, assist us. And so, yes, now that Tata Madiba has passed on, we need to appoint a patron, or we need someone to ask someone to be our patron, and he was the logical choice. So yeah, he didn't actually accept yet. We are still waiting for that. But yes, the offer was made to Mr. Marius Fransman.
All right. Well, now that we've got all the issues out of the way, let's talk more about the actual festivities of it all. We do know it's world famous for the minstrel groups, the colors, the music, the sights, the sounds. Tell us a bit about how this particular festival has grown over the years.
Well, it has grown really big into what we see today, all the visitors from overseas. It is really born in the townships. People take the whole year to save up and to watch the minstrels. And in terms of the minstrels, also people think it's just the end of the year that we have this the show or the preparations. It really goes from year one, from March to March. The preparations never stops, because we want to make a success. And that is how we bring all the different kinds of people in the street to be part of us.
And remind us how Cape Townians and visitors and fellow South Africans can participate in these events. Perhaps you can tell us about where the procession will begin, about the Christmas choirs that are involved, the Malay choirs. Talk us through about how we can get involved.
Well, yeah, there's different elements to the competition. It's the carnival. Then we got the competition running at Greenpoint Stadium. Sorry. At Athlone Stadium, we have the competition running, and there's also another competition at Veegieskraal in Athlone. So that is happening today. We're doing competition items. Obviously, on the 4th Saturday, we will have the big march, which everyone is looking forward to see. And the Malay choirs and the Christmas bands has done their thing on the 21st, and obviously the 31st of January. So that they've still got some upcoming events, but they're going to do that at a later stage. Now it's the minstrels. And today we will do our competition items at the stadiums. And then, of course, like I said, the 4th Saturday we're all ready to do the 4th, the big march, as they say.
You know, we South Africans love a good competition. Tell us a bit about the categories and how people qualify to take part in these competitions.
Well, they don't actually qualify. They just need to apply to become a member, and then they need to. We do about 16 to 17 different items, and it's very competitive, and these people, they really put in a lot to sort of win in this competition, because it's singing, it's dancing, it's different items. It's, you know, the Grand March Pass, which it's a favorite amongst the people. And yeah, and the exhibition, we display, and I see this year a lot of Tata Madiba's face and his sayings and things like that was displayed at the minstrels when they entered the stadium.
Well, sounds like a whole lot of fun. All the best to you for that. And it looks like the weather is playing ball as well, looking very good. Thank you so much again for joining us, and all the best for the event today again. So we're going to give you a glimpse. If you're not in the Mother City and you can't enjoy the Kapsa Kropsa, well, Morning Live will bring you a sneak peek out of what you can expect or what they'll be doing in that part of the country. In just a moment, we take